مثل الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل الله كمثل حبة أنبتت سبع سنابل وكل في فلك يسبحون
ويخلق ما لا تعلمون.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله, اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. Brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to a new episode of our program, The Universal Quran. We are still talking about chapter of An-Naba, and last time we talked about the beginning and we mentioned some blessings and pleasures that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon human beings. And the last thing we ended with last time was about وَخَلَقْنَاكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا, we made you in pairs, the male for the female and so on, and with the same nature. And we said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored all human beings in a way which is over all other creatures, so they should be worth for this honoring and they should be eligible for the job or for the duty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chosen for them, which is to dwell in the land and to populate and so on. So the human beings should go away from anything which is against the nature upon which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created them. As the Prophet ﷺ, he says, مَا مِن مَوْلُودٍ إِلَّا يُولَدُ عَلَى الْفِطْرَةِ. So we have been created in our in the nature that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted us for. And then after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about these things in the beginning of the surah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَجَعَلْنَا نَوْمَكُمْ سُبَاتًا. And which is, this is something very, subhanAllah, amazing and something marvelous about the issue of sleep. If, let us imagine that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created all people without having the ability to sleep, they will die differently. So sleep is renewing your energy, exactly as if you are, for example, driving, and this is just an example which is not the same or the real example, but it's just something closer to the issue we are discussing here. If you have a car, you are driving for long time, for example, for about, for example, 24 hours continuously, otherwise the car will, for example, burn. And the same thing for human beings, you can't remain awake for continuously 1 week, otherwise you might go crazy or you might die. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you this blessing so you can have a kind of rest and you can have a kind of comfort. You are working hard, and then now this is the time when, for example, night comes, you need to have a kind of rest, and you need to just, the body itself is in need for such rest. You can never work for a long time without having a kind of rest, which is giving you exactly like if you are recharging, as if you are charging in the battery. So here you are recharging the body itself. And one of the amazing things that subhanAllah till this moment, doctors and specialists and all those people have no idea about how people sleep, or they had an idea, but they exactly, this is not the exact the same thing, or they didn't come to a conclusion. And they said, for example, okay, sleeping, for example, comes and happens when so and so happens, and no, this is something, maybe one of the secrets that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did, or that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put in human beings. But there are many secrets which will remain unveiled by human beings, or human beings can't find solution for them, or can't know the reality of such secrets. The biggest of which, of course, is the issue of soul or spirit or ar-ruh. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Isra, وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنُ الرُّوحِ قُلِ الرُّوحُ مِنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّي وَمَا أُوتِيتُ مِنْ عِلْمِ لَا قَلِيلًا. When they ask you about the soul or the spirit, say, the knowledge of which is rested with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then all these kinds of knowledge you have is only something very little compared to the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says here, وَجَعَلْنَا نَوْمَكُمْ سُبَاتًا. So if you need to have a kind of rest, you must go to sleep and so on, just to have some break, you know, to recharge your battery, as we said, or to recharge the body itself, in order to, why? In order to work hard again, in order to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the issue of وَجَعَلْنَا نَوْمَكُمْ سُبَاتًا, the issue of noom or sleeping, has been made by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a gift, as something which will make you feel healthy and feel have the ability to work. But even subhanAllah, as we usually know, that Islam taught us everything, and even Islam taught you how to, for example, what should you do before you sleep. You first of all, you need to make wudu. And some people, they have, for example, disorder when they sleep, or they have some problems, they are unable to sleep. What, as a Muslim, what should you do? If you have or you are unable to sleep, you just remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you just make some adhkar and say, in essence, for example, in the West, they have a proverb which says, count the sheep. In Islam, we don't say that. In Islam, we say, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have been given many adhkar that we can make before sleep. Once you start doing these things, if you say, for example, subhanallah 100 times or 200 or less than that, you will find yourself, subhanallah, feel asleep, and then you will sleep safely. Okay, so before doing that, we are recommended by the Prophet ﷺ, instead of going to bed, you need to make wudu. Why? Because sleep reminds us of what? Of course, it does remind us of death. Because sleep, as scholars said, that it is the short or the small death. When you sleep, for example, you are unaware about what's going on around you. So it's exactly as if you died, you know, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will wake you up again. So the death is, you could say, a little warning to you that you might, for example, as a Muslim, and for example, nobody can guarantee how long he's going to live. Nobody, whatever he is, can give me just one guarantee that when he sleep, he will wake up again. No, you can't say that, because the issue of waking up is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he gave you the ability to sleep, and he will give you the ability to wake up again. So it reminds us of death, as which this sometimes might inflict in one of us. Anytime we need to be ready for meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we need to be ready, of course, for that day, and for which is the final end of all creatures. Allah, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Rahman, كل من عليها فان, everything on this earth, in this universe, will come to an end. Plants, people, animals, all creatures that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created must come to an end, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he says in the same surah, وَيَبْقَى وَجْهُ رَبِّكَ ذُو الْجَلَالِ وَالْإِكْرَامِ. So maybe sleeping itself is one of the reminders that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving to you, that you might sleep and, for example, you might be unable to wake up again. So this, you need to be in a continuous state of worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As we know, the creation, or the purpose behind creation, is mainly to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah doesn't want, for example, the number of Muslims to be one or three or whatever, how many billions or millions, no. He just wants them to be good believers and to be devotees to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or to devote part of their time to serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to worship Him. So the naum, or sleeping, as the verse here says, وَجَعَلْنَا نَوْمَكُمْ سُبَاتًا, it has been made a kind of rest and comfort for you when you working hard, when you do all these things. And after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَبَنَيْنَا فَوْقَكُمْ سَبْعًا شِدَادًا, and haven't we built over you the seven firmaments, or the firm seven skies that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created. Also, وَجَعَلْنَا السَّمَاءَ بُرُوجًا وَزَيَّنَّاهَا لِلنَّاظِرِينَ. So the skies, as the verse says in Surah Al-Hijr, as maybe a kind of decoration that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He built them, or He raised them, and then have been beautified or decorated by very, very nice and very marvelous stars as a way of decoration, as He says in the other surah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and He placed therein a light of splendor. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided us with two things. He provided us with the sun during the day, for example, so you can get some heat and you can see. For example, some countries or some areas, they don't have electricity, so they mainly depend on the sun during the day, and then on the moon during the night.
Back to the Prophet. Join Sheikh Amar in the program Back to the Prophet, wherein he teaches us practical lessons from the Prophet's life and how this can help us to overcome our challenges in the present.
We talk about the life example of the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, seeking guidance for ourselves. In the early days after the revelation of the Holy Quran, the Muslims were greatly persecuted, so much so that quite a few Muslims had to leave Arabia and migrate to Africa to live among Ahl Kitab, Christian people who followed the Gospel of Christ.
يهدي به الله من اتبع
وجعلنا سراجا وهاجا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided us with the sun, as I have just said. You use it when electricity, for example, goes off, and in many countries nowadays, you could say invented some device that mainly work by the sun, like for example some cars, and like for example heating systems, and it is being used as one of the sources for energy nowadays in some areas. The same thing for the moon. Some sailors, they still depend on the moon and the stars in knowing the directions, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah An-Nahl, وَعَلَامَاتٍ وَبِالنَّجْمِ هُمْ يَهْتَدُونَ. By the stars they can be guided. And all these things have been made by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or been provided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for our own welfare and for our own comfort and benefit. And but sometimes, subhanAllah, human beings are ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the verse in Surah Al-Adiyat, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لِرَبِّهِ لَكَنُودٍ. Indeed, he is not grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He, on the contrary, he describes other partners with him. The worst thing is to ascribe, because if you even, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us away from these things, if you want to ascribe, so it's something similar, and nothing of course will never be similar to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he said in Surah Shura, laysa kamithlihi shay. But the worst thing is when human beings, for example, think about worshipping what? Now I hear that some people, they worship rats, and they built temples for such rats. In some countries, people still worship cows. Okay, of the cow, or if the rat, for example, dies, your Lord or your God dies. So where is your mind? Where is your mentality that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided you with? Don't you think about that? Don't you think that the cow or the rat or this statue, like some people, for example, worship? So does it benefit you? And if the God can be seen, so it's no longer God, because God can't be seen here. He is the dominator, or he is dominating the whole universe, and you can't see him, because if you see him, this means that you can argue with him and you can refuse his orders, and you can say, no God, I don't like that, I object, I oppose, I don't accept your opinion. No, this is not the right case. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has no equal, and there is nobody similar to him, as he says or confirms this truth in chapter of Al-Ikhlas, sincerity, or Qul Wallahu Ahad. He says, وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. Nobody is similar to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and nothing even is equal to him. So when you degenerate or undermine yourself to worship a statue or an animal, for example, or anybody, so this is why. Let us ask ourselves one question that most of the times come to my mind: why people should do that? I'll tell you why. Because people do not like, for example, to be given orders. Nobody wants to be directed. You should do that and you shouldn't do that. You should, for example, pray, and you should pay zakah, you should go for hajj, you shouldn't speak about people in a bad way, you shouldn't. And he hates these things, he hates these commands. He needs a God that he can design himself. Like Sayyidina Umar, when he converted to Islam, he said, they found him laughing, and they said to him, oh Umar, what made you laugh? And he said, before Islam, in the Jahiliyyah, I used to make my own God out of sweet, and then after that, when I feel hungry, I eat it. So what God is that? People are looking for comfort, are looking for a God that doesn't speak, and that doesn't give order at all. For example, the cow doesn't give any orders. The rat can never give an order, okay? The statue can never speak. So they are looking for the god that they made themselves, that they designed themselves, a god which is suitable for any time, a god which is suitable for any age, a god that cannot speak, cannot give orders, and that god will never be displeased with you, and he will never be pleased because animals have no feelings and statues can't talk. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not like all these things, and he is superior to all humanity. He is superior to all other creatures. He is superior to the whole universe, because in clear words he created them, so he is dominating them, and he can deal with them as he likes or as he wills. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wajalna, and As I mentioned the story of the debate between Prophet Ibrahim and the tyrant Nimrud, Sayyidina Ibrahim, when he told him that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is bringing the sun from the east, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creates death and life, not similar to as in Nimrud, for example, when he was told that, he said, yes, I do the same thing. And Sayyidina Ibrahim asked him, how? He said, okay, if somebody is going to be punished, I would spare that, and then I punish somebody else, so that the other one will die and the other will live. And Sayyidina Ibrahim, when he found this person is arrogant, he told him, okay, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is bringing the sun from the east. Can he bring it from the west? And then he was defeated, and his claim was refuted by Sayyidina Ibrahim. These things, I mean, the sun, the moon, the stars, and these kinds of gifts or pleasure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides us with, nobody can claim that. But sometimes people, because of the power they have, they think that they are superior to all humanity, or they are gods. An example is Pharaoh, when he said to his people, مَا عَلِمْتُ لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَهٍ غَيْرِي, I know no god for you except me. And he said, I am your superior, or I am your higher lord, in Surah An-Nazaat, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated. فَحَشَرَ فَنَادَ فَقَالَ أَنَا رَبُّكُمْ الْأَعْلَى. He's just a human being. Who are you to claim that? And who are you to claim, for example, a prophet? And you know that Prophet Muhammad ﷺ was the last messenger that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent in the chain of messengers who were charged by the duty of proclaiming the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and conveying the message of Islam, conveying the message of monotheism or tawheed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَجَعَلْنَا سِرَاجًا وَهَاجًا, and after that, after he made or provided you with light during the day and night, I mean the sun and the moon, after that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَجَعَلْنَا وَأَنْزَلْنَا مِنَ الْمُعْصِرَاتِ مَاءً ثَجَّاجًا. So he provided you with all things by which you can live. He didn't create you, for example, without giving you fruits, vegetables. And now here he says, وَأَنْزَلْنَا مِنَ الْمُعْصِرَاتِ, from the clouds Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down ma'an thajjaja. People said thajjaja means that in great amounts, or for example continuously. So as we watch, sometimes the rain, sometimes they come continuously, or they come, for example, in great amounts. And by water, life would become stable. If there is no water, for example, all creatures, animals, plants, human beings themselves will die. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us many examples about water and what does water do, for example, to the land. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Hajj, فَانْزَلْنَا عَلَيْهِ الْمَاءَ اهْتَزَّتْ وَرَبَتْ وَأَنْبَتَتْ مِنْ كُلِّ زَوْجٍ بَهِيجَةٍ. When water comes to, for example, any field or to any ground, grow well. Different kinds of plants and different kind of vegetables will grow and will come for the benefit of human beings. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says here, لِنُخْرِجَ بِهِ حَبًّا وَنَبَاتًا. The Quran, as I said, gave many examples about water and what does do, for example, to the land. If you have a piece of land and it is barren, for example, and then suddenly an amount of water fall down, loads of different kinds of plants will grow immediately. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not immediately, I mean after a while. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also gives another example in chapter of Al-Kahf. He says, وَضْرِبْ لَهُمْ مَثَلَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا كَمَاءٍ أَنْزَلْنَاهُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ فَاخْتَلَطَ بِهِ نَبَاتُ الْأَرْضِ فأصبح هشيما تذروه الرياح وكان الله على كل شيء مقتدرا. So this life, dunya is like that. Dunya is like a piece of land which was barren, and then an amount of water fall down, and then some plants, for example, grow. And after that, if you have a tree or a kind of plant, and it will grow, and then it will become old, and after that, it will fall down, and it will come to an end. So this is life. Although it might look nice, it might look beautiful in our eyes, but at the end, it is just tempting you. As the Prophet ﷺ said in the seventh hadith, إن الله إن الدنيا خضرة حلوة وإن الله مستخلفكم فيها فناظر كيف تعملون فاتقوا الدنيا واتقوا النساء. Allah سبحانه وتعالى is just giving you a kind of test. He made life beautiful, sweet to you, just to test you and to know whether you are going to fall in these temptations or you are going to remember Allah سبحانه وتعالى. As Sayyidina Yusuf عليه الصلاة والسلام, when he was invited by the lady to commit immorality, he remembered Allah سبحانه وتعالى and he said, Allah سبحانه وتعالى has been good to me and will be good to me. I will never betray the covenant that I have made with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to have a kind of covenant with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to avoid anything which might make him displeased with our deeds. So by water, the verse says, say لَنُخْرِجَ بِحَبًّا وَنَبَاتًا وَجَنَّاتٍ أَلْفَافًا. Through water we can have different kinds of vegetables and different kinds of fruits. And through water also, life can never go without water. If people, for example, if water stops coming, and then definitely all creatures on this planet will die and will vanish. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's the secret anyway behind this life, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us all these things by which we can live and upon which we depend. And also, in order to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and in order to remember this blessing that He provided you, because you are His own creature. And He challenged the angels when He said to them, "Inni ja'alun fil ardi khalifa," I'm going to make a vicegerent. And they said to Him, "How can you make somebody or this vicegerent who is going to do mischief?" And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "Inni a'lamu ma la ta'lamun," I know what you do not know. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam, and from Adam came Eve, and so on. So in general, we are indebted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Really, last night I had a cup of cold water, and I said, subhanallah, if we just remember this blessing, this ni'mah, we will never be ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember that many people are deprived of this blessing. Remember that hundreds or thousands or maybe millions of people are dying because they don't find a drop of water. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you this blessing, so you need to take care of it. You shouldn't use water in an extravagant way or in a way that we have a sound hadith. The Prophet says, even if you are living close to a river, you shouldn't be extravagant in using water, or you should be rational in using water in a good way, because many people will get benefit of it, and it will pass by many people. So everybody must have his share of water, and so on. And this blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon us, in order to be grateful to Him, in order to remember His blessings, in order not to be complaining all the time. Most people complain nowadays because sometimes, although they have been given many blessings, but they say, okay, we are living in poverty, we need more, I am looking for a good house, I am looking for a new car. And he doesn't remember those people who are lower than him. He is, for example, a professor, he doesn't remember those people who have no job at all. He is a millionaire, he doesn't remember those people who are moneyless, and so on. So as the Prophet ﷺ, he told us, if you want to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gifts that He bestowed upon you, remember those who are lower than you and those who were deprived of many things. You have been given many, many gifts and health and all these things. Remember that a lot of people do not have sound health like the one you have. Remember that many people do not have money as you have. Remember many, many things. Many people have no house at all. They are homeless, and alhamdulillah, you are living in a very spacious and luxurious house, which is very good to you. So these things are to, and you will be asked about them, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah At-Takathur, ثُمَّ لَتَسْأَلُنَّ يَوْمَئِذٍ عَنِ النَّعِيمِ. You will be asked about the blessings. You will be asked about the luxurious life that you, for example, led. You will be asked about all gifts that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you before, because you are like a trustee over that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you this in order to test you. At the end, I thank you for being very good listeners. And until we meet again, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
وترى الجبال تحسبها جامدة وهي تمر مر السحاب صنع الله الذي أتقن كل شيء إنه خبير بما تفعلون
مثل الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل الله كمثل حبة أنبتت سبع سنابل
وكل في فلك يسبحون
ويخلق ما لا